played the game on my practice channel. Practice account, sorry. If you would like to follow me, you can follow me on facebook.com, Hammers Reviews, also Twitter, twitter.com. So about that, I was listening to music. My Twitter is twitter.com. Blueboy85. My Instagram is instagram.com hemsreviews1. The reason I'm streaming so late because my neighbours thought they'd be funny and fucking clang fucking doors. My Twitch is twitch.tv Blueboy1985. I have a donation link if you would like to help me raise funds for my new computer desk. I have a donation link on the main page of my Twitch. My YouTube channel is youtube.com Hammers Reviews. If you don't have PayPal for donations, you can use my Patreon, which is patreon.com Hammers Reviews. And my Twitch isn't fucking working. It's been a complete wanker. Except if you're English. Sometimes I'm blind as a fucking bat.
Introducing the Ghost Experience. The Ghost Experience lets you choose between two different ways to play the PvE version of Ghost Recon Breakpoint. Regular, the way the game was released, and immersive, a new way to experience the game. While regular lets you play with weapons and gear of different levels and rarity, immersive mode removes the notion of gear score entirely. The new tactical settings will change the way you play. New HUD settings are all...
Share button on my Twitch isn't working. Either Twitch is down My PSN is Hammers Reviews 85 if anyone would like to tag along or bloomingly 85 for anyone that would like to play the game. Just gotta get my charger cable. I'm gonna be extremely tired later on. I haven't played a Ghost Recon game in quite a long time. I think the last one I played was on Xbox 360. I think it was called Ghost Recon Future Warriors.
Welcome to Auroa, the incubator of World 2.0. My name's Jay Skell, and we've been expecting you. You've been invited here to innovate, to invent, and to create. But we're also asking you to do the most important thing with your lives that you can do. Here, away from the rest of the world, we will build the tools to lead the planet into the future. A completely sustainable economy, a blossoming environment, safe homes, security for your family, and a community where innovation is celebrated. The generations that come after us may forget all about us, but they will thrive because of the work we do here. Thank you for joining Skelltech in Auroa. Together, we are building tomorrow.
That's the interpretation that way on the USS. Maybe it's Mr. Something or happened here. I would have been pissed with a capital P. Well, this is our bloody day, it really is.
God damn it.
There are faction missions on this. For someone that's no longer alive, still, I think this is actually a fault. They don't follow me, people. You're very wrong in that. I didn't think I would like the concrete, but it's been a very long time since I played. I think the last time I played, I believe it was 2006. We have a professor. I think we have a professor around. The professor goes on.
Nothing could have survived that shit.
Shit!
Contact! One of the hostiles survived! Huh? How you like that shit? Ah!
Luckily, this should be. Yeah, no one knocked at this time. Don't worry if you. The goal for YouTube likes will be, if I can get at least 10 views and say 10 likes, I really appreciate that. I've been playing so many games lately. Later on we do get a drone. That was everything I played on my practice account. Sometimes I do play games on that account for the YouTube channel. Which I sort of have a I've only got one weapon so far. Bless me, huh? From what I know so far, is someone that we thought we could trust. But Michael Ironside is from the television show Ironside. It's very hard to explain what Ironside is. I've only watched it a handful of times and I wouldn't be able to tell you what it's about, so the map is massive. This is PvP area up here. Column Island. On my practice so far, this game has taken over 140 plus hours. Because I've tried to get everything, so if everyone's in this for the long haul, I do not mind. That is in there. Big note from Minus. Okay. We have little investigations. something. Sorry, PvE, sorry. It's a Golem Island. Down. Well, I don't know. I'll go to this one for now. Suppressor is always a good thing to have. I will be doing dedicated after two short questions.
Shit. My soldiers.
I don't know if he is the leader. My future of choice is Glover.
Damn it.
I have made some new friends on my map. Other people are really confident from some of the people. Yes, I did say, or someone takes along with me, I said, you just have my friend. Most will say yes. He's a very good player. That I've been teaming up with.
Can happen, even someone surviving that slaughter.
Who the hell is that?
This is ridiculous.
Now, credit is like triple potency. Then people will know and play every triple potency. Into my cryptocurrencies. I have found a browser that rewards you with cryptocurrency, the basic attention token, will back the short, basically, reward people for attention. Say you watch a whole video, and on some streaming platforms, we're going to delve with some delve. Yeah. Sure you are. That's what happens when you want to do things.
No sign of survivors here. They have to be dead.
Man, these are real deal spec ops badasses. They can survive way worse than this. Look at
it. Currently, I think I'm level 200. I'd normally like to have a sniper rifle up there. So let's bang hand grenade. Later on,
no sign of survivors so far.
We have to sweep this whole area to call it clear.
Strange.
Send your own people.
God, this place is a shithole. Yeah, they'd never get through here.
Well, whatever the hell they were testing out here, I hope it's not.
I got eyes on a ghost!
So I'm gonna try something different. So we have bonus shotgun. Okay. On my practice one, I'm the field medic. I'm going with the assault. Night vision that may come in handy later on. Parachute. That is also good. Oh, excuse me. I think there is a day one mission on here as well, but I haven't actually done said mission.
There's got to be somebody.
There must be self-crushing to see everything go to shit.
Cloud 1-1, this is Weaver. Come in. Over. This is Weaver. Come in. Over.
Anything?
Ugats. Contact. Contact.
Weaver.
You boss. bastard.
Walker. What the hell are you doing?
Can do that. Kill enemies with a firearm. That can be any firearm, so. I cannot get through this area because it is a level 100. They have to be. The Terminator mission is pretty good. It's the best in the game. You must be gut-wrenching knowing that someone that you're very, I think the guy Walker is the commanding officer. That's the interpretation. Hello, do anyone want to just join me live? Hope you're all doing fine. What I'm gonna do is normally I put a designated marksman rifle or an assault rifle up here. So let's see what we can do. Damn off the pressure, that'll do for now. That'll do nicely. The chats are interactive, so if you want to ask anything, do not be afraid to ask. I normally use the dual range light. Is the audio okay or is it too loud? Please let me know in the chat section below.
Mayday, mayday. This is Ghost Lead. Does anyone read?
555, Ghost Lead.
Who is this?
A friend. I got the radio from a ghost.
This ghost still breathing?
Ghost Lead, you can chase the White Rabbit.
Or run with the Red Queen. Give me a sit rep.
That can wait. Your man's getting medical treatment. Follow the trail behind the ancient ruins. Your destination is in the mountains between two waterfalls.
Understood. Ghost Lead out.
Let's see what our next level task is. Kill enemies using drill bit, kill enemies with an assault rifle or a shotgun. Okay then, true, but I'm gonna have to see how to do that. So, experience upgrade, pack me with night vision or parachute. know what I'm doing. Ten ranks, some of them are very tricky, so...
pops out of the mud and slits your throat. And I'm not gonna help you.
Oh no.
What the? On the line, we got a survivor!
I'm guessing somewhere in the lane could be very wrong. I really do need a cup of coffee right now. I know I'm not the best friend in the world, but everyone has to start somewhere. This is called Operation Brimstone. And there's collectibles. I I did get rather stumped. I do not know what kilometers are, unfortunately. That is a SMG machine gun, very good. Don't think I will use that just yet. I'm gonna this is a different face paints you can get. Ubisoft tech support for this game isn't very good. Got Deadwood, and we've got Hexagon tattoo. That's how some people feel sometimes. They feel dead on the inside. That looked very tribal. That was like what is a Nomad exactly? That is pretty good. Did not know that you can edit. You can't edit the color of everything, but some things you can. Of a choice would be aviators. I'll just keep with what I've got for now. I could really see myself. So I'm going to... That is a cool design. Thank you. change on that, I get. I'll keep that as. I can normally find it, what I'm looking for. So everybody can hear me. Because that just confuses me. And not the fact that he didn't want to do it, but for the life of me, I cannot find it at the moment. tells me what to do. When it gets into morals, I understand where it's coming from. Other than that, I don't understand. We've received multiple streams today, so don't you worry. If Ghost Recon is not your cup of tea, I am doing fire code orders. No. I got carried away with some side bitch. Happy days. Armageddon! Get off the bloody way, you bastard. Animal protein. Plant animals. I think the guy is called Holt, right, what we're looking for. And some others. I will have to make some more energy for later on.
Or what?
The only two left in our chalk. No radio, no drones. Between the two of us, we got two rifles and eight mags.
Locals got water here. And some supplies.
Nomad, and the officer in charge of this operation.
By operation, I assume you mean a massively wild screw-up.
Hey, old man. You playing nice?
He's trying to find out why a bunch of grunts are falling from the sky into our laps, honey.
Someone sank a naval cargo ship off the coast. Then the entire archipelago overall went dark. Now, we were sent here to figure out what happened. Next thing we know, the choppers were taken down. Almost half of my soldiers are dead.
Best we can tell, some kind of military takeover. Sentinel, military contractors, they put this place under martial law, using the old boot in the neck technique to enforce it.
Skeltec is still making all the high-tech stuff they always make. Except maybe now they're making more weapons. Not exactly the libertarian utopia J-Skell advertised.
Where can I find J-Skell?
They had a Skeltec himself. We haven't seen him, but his drones are keeping an eye on his islands.
So you think he's still a part of this?
We're just not sure why.
I'll put figuring it out on my to-do list. For now, I see her wounded.
Yeah. One of your guys needs to rest, but he won't shut up. Calm him down, yeah? And then come find me. I'll give you the guided tour.
This will be over an hour, stranger. Attachment objective, okay. Yeah, 60 plus weapons to find. Not all of them are easy to come by. Oh, excuse me. Oh. Some of these you can't actually do until later on. The enemy of my enemy. That's a lot later on. Won't have to do that a bit later on. We can't do any of. We can do the faction support missions. Don't like shotguns. Let's see who we've got. I think his name's Hull.
Oh. Hey. Who are you, man?
Nomad. Who's left? Who made it?
Hey, you just relax, pal. I'm doing what I can.
Here's another superpower.
We finally have a drone.
I can't find Midas. Weaver. Just relax. We'll take care of it, all right?
The wasp.
Yeah. When the comms blackout, I can't reach the ship. I'll talk to Matt Schultz. Big gun. He might have a boat I can use. Don't you worry. I'll come back with some help.
Go.
See what we can do.
Weaver was a good dude.
I'll say. He didn't take a dump without checking his gear.
Well, he didn't take any chances.
How'd he do it?
Don't.
How did he do it?
He executed him. Like he was some rabid dog.
Backstabbing piece of shit.
I wonder if Midas made it.
That dude crossed the border outside Juarez, blackout drunk in ranger panties and flip-flops. If anyone can hold it together out here, it's him.
God, remember that?
If he's out there, we got a shot.
Maybe.
Give me the three of us. You, me, Midas. We'll find that piece of shit, Walker. Run him right into the ground. We got to. For Weaver.
You're not exactly in fighting shape right now, man. You gonna be able to walk again?
I better. This ain't no way for me to go out.
You get some rest, pal. Later, brother.
Later.
Little mission. I know how to do it, Henshaw. Joked on Evil Town already.
How's it going?
I'm good. But listen, I need to show you something. Over there on the table. Recognize him?
Yeah, his name is Victor Cost. He's old school Black Ops.
My guess is he's here with the CIA.
Well, if he's a mole, then he might be able to help us.
From what I can tell, his location is somewhere near the channels. You might want to start by looking there.
All right, I'll head over and see what I can dig up. This was a good find.
Glad I can help, even if I am all digged up.
Nope, I don't want to do that just yet. But pumping that for now. Wonder why they joined. Lieutenant Cole D. Walker. The thing is, what turns these people?
Some kind of problem?
We're not sure. Our friend Samuel's missing.
You a homesteader?
He used to be. Before he decided he'd rather live by himself. No great loss, if you ask me.
He likes catching his own food. Says it keeps him closer to nature. Something like that. And then he gives the furs and leftover meat to the camp. Never takes anything in return.
I don't get it. Sounds like he knows how to take care of himself.
Last week, he was down here hollering about running into a bunch of sentinels on his land. Said they carried away a couple of deer he caught, smashed up his traps, and then this week, nothing. Samuel's always had a temper, but in this place, these days, say the wrong thing to the wrong person, well, you know.
Yeah, I know. Say, where are his usual stomping grounds?
He's typically around to the southeast of Garden Mangrove, northeastern part of Guyaron.
I'll see if I can find him. Thanks. Thanks a million.
Well, man, tell that in the short mission.
How do you fit into this whole Skeletech design?
I was the head of the Civic Engineering Department. Guess you could say I resigned over creative differences regarding Titan.
So you had something to do with designing the infrastructure here on Auroa?
Sort of. I build on top of what the New Zealand and US military started. Every culture has to do that. Build on top of existing infrastructure. The older the culture, the more infrastructure is already in place, the harder it is to modernize. That's why Europe is such a mess.
Why not just tear it up and start over?
Once you build something, like roads, you don't want to unbuild them. Plus, Skell wanted to keep all the existing structures in place as a way to preserve the island.
That seems like a pain in the ass.
I don't mind a challenge. That's what makes me so good at what I do.
So I guess your roads are going to be a problem for the next person that comes here to design infrastructure.
I doubt it. By the time my roads need to be reworked, people will be flying around Auroa on jetpacks.
All these drones must use a massive amount of power.
We use more electricity than most third world countries.
So if we pull the plug, we can shut the whole operation down.
There's no plug. The whole island is powered by a diverse renewable power grid. There are multiple power sources and no one source power. And all the power sources are renewable. None of them need fuel.
So you built a lethal drone army and gave it unlimited power. No one thought that might be a problem.
Skeletech, our power came from environmentally friendly sources. We have the cleanest power grid on Earth. Also the most expensive. Maybe people like you are the reason Skell had to build his utopia way out here in the middle of nowhere.
How many of these renewable power sources are there?
There's a massive solar panel farm outside Liberty and wind turbines on the west coast. There are also two oceanic geothermal plants in the channels between the islands. Those are powered by cold water from Antarctica and warm water from the Pacific.
There must be some kind of battery where they store all the excess power.
Just north of Liberty, there's a dam. Inside are flywheel capacitors. That's where the energy is stored.
Sounds like you built this power grid to be rock solid. I guess it's gonna be impossible to turn the lights off.
Sorry, I built this place to last.
That's the scary thing about this World 2.0 you built. It can't be rebooted. All these drones must use a massive amount of power.
We use more electricity.
So if we pull the plug, we can shut...
There's no plug. The whole island is
So you built...
Skell insisted our maybe people like...
How many of...
There's a massive solar panel farm outside Liberty.
There must be some...
Just north of Liberty.
It might be Utopia. It looks like Skell bought himself one hell of a power grid. The rest of the world might collapse. The world would be...
If you're planning to ride out the end of the world, it helps being a multi-billionaire.
That's the scary thing about this World 2.0 you built. Can't be rebooted. All these drones must use.
We use multiple. There's no plug.
So you.
Skell insisted. Maybe.
How many of.
There's a massive solar panel farm outside.
There must be.
Just north of.
Why couldn't we just destroy the power grid? There's no way to disrupt the swarms by just smashing the electric box.
This power grid is a model for a sustainable future, and all you want to do is destroy it? Besides, you can't knock it out. Designed to have backups for backups. Even if all that fails, we have energy stored in the flywheel capacitors. The lights are never going off on Auroa.
That's the scary thing about this World 2.0 you built. It can't be rebooted. What kind of air traffic do you get on the island?
Before the perimeter of drones made leaving the island impossible, the only people flying in or out were investors or vacationers. To be honest, we didn't have much air traffic. Why do you ask?
I saw an airport earlier. We might be able to land a bird in there.
To evacuate people?
Or explore. I'm just spitballing here.
The Auroa airport near Infinity has the big runway. But that's where all the international flights come in.
Any smaller airstrips? Somewhere they can land helos.
Try Liberty Airport. We use it for internal jumper flights. If you're snooping around there, just be careful. Sentinel uses both of them, so they're crawling with security.
What's with the fancy net there on Erewhon's crater?
Well, it's hardly a net, but yes, it is fancy. It's bleeding-edge, multi-layered camouflage equipment that blocks visibility with surrounding environmental patterns. More importantly, it fools the drones. It's how I keep Erewhon hidden and virtually impossible to find.
So it works the way a chameleon would, letting into the background.
A little more advanced, but yes. The fabric uses a signature management system that disrupts thermal patterns, infrared wavelengths, and radio emissions so drones can't run their recognition algorithms. It won't fool a human eye. I mean, if somebody was looking at a drone feed, they might notice something weird, but...
Nobody can check thousands of hours of video feed on Auroa.
Right. It makes hiding things from drones pretty easy. They can't respond to what they don't see. It was developed by Skelltech. Luckily, I just so happen to know how to hijack it. Now Erewhon can remain safe for at least a little while.
Like your style, Jericho. I'll see you around.
Sure. I'll be seeing you.
If we could... Spock left over points for that grip dog, haven't he? That would be good. I'm not starting that mission yet. I'm doing it in part two.
Lucky you found this place. Rowan Brown knew about this place for a while. We figured sacred ground always makes good sanctuary. That's pretty damp, though. Still a work in progress, all right? We've managed to stay under the radar so far. With all of you, our people, a bunch of Skelltech employees. I don't think you've got room to complain.
Hey, I'm not complaining. This place is great.
It'd be a pretty island without all the military contractors and killer drones. Used to be. I get some leave and just walk. It's been whole weeks just walking around with a pack on my shoulder.
Well, I'm probably getting my share of sightseeing.
These islands have changed hands so much, it's like a time capsule. I keep telling myself, one day, I'll get back out there, just see it all again before I'm too old to make the trip. Then again, who knows how far I get now.
You don't look like Skelltech employees.
No. I used to be a Marine at the naval station here. Some of the folks you see, like Maria, my old lady, they lived on the station with their families. When the Navy shut the place down in the 90s, a few of us stayed and homesteaded. We worked a long time to make a place for ourselves on Auroa.
And now, we're in Sentinel's way.
Most of my people are holing up here for now. I'll stand by any man.
Gonna be really bloody sad today.
Can stay as long as you don't cause trouble. And you lend a hand.
We appreciate it. How's everything been going?
Classic shit sandwich. We're the damn mustard.
What now?
After the epidemic, Sentinel stepped up attacks on our people. Now it looks like everyone's finally listening to me and coming to Auroa.
And that's bad.
It is when we're nearly doubling the amount of people in just a few days. People are crammed in, restless, angry. Spend most of my days stopping fights.
Just remind them of the real enemy. They need you to lead them against Sentinel.
First priority is keeping my people alive. Next is fighting Sentinel.
We had a deal, Mads. After the virus, you joined the fight.
These people aren't soldiers. They aren't under my command. We're gonna take our time and we're gonna fight smarter. One wrong move and we're all wiped out.
How's everything been going?
Classic shit, Sam.
What now?
After the... Now, listen.
And that's...
It is. People are cramped.
Just remind...
First priority.
You can't hide forever. Sentinel is coming for you whether you like it or not.
Sure, but I still gotta be smart about our operations. Throwing men and more Sentinel traps ain't helping anyone.
How's everything
classic
short now?
After
if I do all of the options.
First priority.
I understand. Think of it this way. Sooner we win, sooner you get out of this cave.
You sure know how to tease me.
Talk to you later. See ya.
Thank you all for watching. You've been a great audience, and I'll be back later on when I'm a bit more awake with more Ghost Recon Breakpoint. I have been your host, Blueboy1985, and I bid you all a farewell for now.